Everybody, welcome back. And this is my campsite that I made. I made this about 4 months ago. I've camped here a couple of times. Just a little campground I got. This was just a big, like, briar patch is what you call it. And then one day I just kind of drove back in here, crushed a lot of it, and then I slowly started. Actually, what I did do, I'd grab pine needles and throw them, and then anytime I'd see a piece of grass or something, I'd kind of dig it. So now I've got this nice flat spot. So you can see over there, I got a little campfire, fire pit. I've got my little grate, and pretty much over here, which I'll bring you guys a little closer here. Also, if you hear guns, it's just my neighbors. They're sighting guns, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, there's a bough over here. This is where my hammock goes. So right here's this bough. So you can see it hangs down pretty low here. And all I did was I have a little stick here because I didn't want to cut this bough down, because whenever I have my tent here, I use it as kind of like cover. Because if you haven't noticed, I'm along a dirt road right here. This is pretty much the pine grove is where I'm at. But it makes a really nice little campsite. And it's supposed to rain tonight, I'm pretty sure. But shouldn't be bad. But as you can see, I've got paracord and it pulls this bough up. Because like I said, I really didn't want to cut this bough. I didn't want to cut it down. We'll tie off here. And I just let it sit and it holds the bough up enough to where I don't got to cut it down. So yeah, it's a nice little campsite. If you turn around this way, you can see that I've got a little trail here. See how it kind of goes up around? I'll show you real quick. I spent quite a bit of time making this in the summer. You can't really tell now because there's tons of pine needles on it, but here's my trail. I'll just walk it a second. And comes up through here, comes up under the pine trees. That's the trail right here. And goes up through there. But I made a little bed here so I can plant some wildflowers next year. Looks like we've had a raccoon down here doing something. Mr. Raccoon, maybe we'll hear him tonight. But yeah, I mean, it's a nice little spot. It's nice I'm in a rural area. I always hate saying that because I got nice space. Even though I'm next to a road, you can't even tell. It's crazy. But yep, first thing I gotta do is set up my hammock. So let me go ahead and grab that. And what I'm gonna do off camera is put up the tarp that goes over the rain fly. So let me do that real quick. Hey guys, so here's my rain fly. I got it set up, and next we just gotta put the hammock up. But if you're wondering what this is the Sway Hammocks era setup, and this is the rain fly that comes with it, and also it's a down insulated hammock. So I've used it quite a bit. I did a review video on it. They sent it to me for free, you know, to review and show off and everything. But if I'm being honest, I really like the bag. It's a really nice setup. And yeah, comes up, you know, with the rain fly, like I said. You just tie it off a few points. Then it's got four little like bungee straps that stake out to the ground. So it's a really quick setup. And first time I've used the rain fly down here, I'm pretty sure. So yeah, we're gonna need it. It's gonna be some cold rain later if it does rain. It was sprinkling a bit ago, but hopefully it doesn't like downpour later. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get the hammock set up now, right under the rain fly. And actually, let me grab it real quick. Let me show you guys. Here's. It fits into a nice little bag. It's not a big bag, but here it is. Obviously shrinks down once it's in the bag, but nice and poofy. So these are the straps. If you get the bundle, you get this hammock, the straps, and the rain fly. So let me get the straps set up, and we'll hook the sleeping bag up, or the hammock. We're gonna put the hammock up, guys. Okay guys, so there's the setup. Looks really weird on the camera. Looks like that's really low, but it's in a good spot. And you can see under here, and that goes all the way over that way. It's a nice little roof on top of it. But this should do pretty well. I haven't really been in the rain in a hammock just yet, so if it does rain, we'll see how it is. But what I have planned for later is I have half a pound of Canadian bacon, and I have a bag of, I think it was broccoli cheese noodles or something like that. And also I fixed my jet boil, so I'm going to use my jet boil to boil water, and I'll probably get a little fire going for when I cook the Canadian bacon. If not, though, we'll use the jet boil as well. But yeah, this is a nice little cozy place to go, and make sure this is all secure here. Make sure it's nice and safe. And yeah, so far I've done it pretty well whenever I do this hammock, and I don't know why, but I like it nice and low. I'm a good foot off the ground with this all the way, you know, squatted down when I'm on it, but I like being real low on the ground. I don't know why, I just do. You know, you can set stuff around you and just do whatever. I mean, sometimes I've had it, you know, a good 4 foot in the air, but I don't know, it feels cozy when you're on the ground like this to me. But you know, this is well off the ground here, so that good foot, I'm not gonna get wet, you know, nothing's gonna happen like that. So yeah, I like it. What I might do is I have a couple of tarps that I brought, and I might see if I can hang those up as well. See if I can hang them up. It's a reflective one, so if I had a little fire here while I'm in my hammock like this, I'd have it reflect back on me this way. I know there's one thing I'd like to say about this this rain fly I got. With this rain fly, wind really blows it around. So if you mix strong winds with rain, you're gonna get wet. So I'm probably gonna do that. Next time you see me, we're probably gonna be cooking up some food, and yeah. I might swing here just for a bit after I shut the camera off. But, yeah. Guess I'll see you then. I need to get just a little bit of firewood if I want some, you know, a little campfire later. And, I'm gonna see if I can put that tarp up. So, next time you see me, I might be talking about a tarp being up. It's either that or I'm gonna be cooking food or something else. So, I'll see you guys then.
Okay, guys. So, I decided on, hanging up the tarp. I felt like this wouldn't be enough, especially if a wind gust come through. So what I got going here is there's that rain fly, the little gray one. And then lapping over top of it, as you can see the shadow up there, I have this one, and it is a reflective one. And what I did was I tied it up there on the same two trees that I tied to the top of that one. And then almost to the bottom, I tied it, because there's two tie-off points here. I tied one of the sides to the base of that tree and the other side to the base of that tree, so it created the short wall right here. So you see how there's like a little wall? And pretty much what that is going to do is now I have a sheltered place that I can cook my food. So if it's raining or whatnot, I can go ahead and just stay, and I can sit in the hammock here. Pretty much. Let me just show you what I'm trying to say. Okay, guys, so say I'm coming in here. That side is looking towards the campfire, and now I'm on the inside here. So I can sit down in my hammock like this, since I like it low like this. Also, another thing, the actual hammock, you know, discluding the underquilt layer that's around this, it's all the way up to here. So pretty much with this hammock, there's a nice pocket of warm air between you and the underquilt. So it's separate. Instead of cold air being there normally, you've got a nice warm layer of air. So that's why it's so baggy, is because it's creating a pocket. But this is what I was trying to say is, right now I'm completely covered from rain. I know it's going to rain. There's no way it's not. And there is a little bit of a space here that if rain come down like this angle, it might come through, but all it would do is drip over here. So now that I've got my little wall here, I'm going to set my gear against that side of the wall. Also, I've got
some little, you know, I don't know what you call them, little posts that I had down here, and I laid them so they made the wall more sturdier at the bottom. But pretty much I just lay my gear alongside that wall so it won't get wet or anything. Keep the frost off it. There might be a frost tonight. And pretty much I'll just cook right here with my jet boil right in front of my feet. And I'll have all my food under here. So I think this is a pretty good setup. Other than that, if it rains later, you know, I'm going to have to set up a tarp in the rain, or I'll just have to wait to eat. And, you know, because I can't cook it under here. The thing with this rain fly that comes with this is it only covers that space. I know there's a lot of tarps you can buy for hammocks, you know, and they spread a pretty big space. And you have enough to have gear under it and everything. But this, it's kind of like a hot dog and a hot dog. They just, it matches right up. It's the same length, same size. So, if you have a hammock like this or a rain fly, definitely take a tarp. But, yeah, what I'm going to go ahead and do now is I have a little, you know, if I can grab it, without falling over here, I have a little, like, hoe slash, it's like a pickaxe kind of thing here. And I'm going to make just a little space here where I'm going to cook so it's nice and flat. So that's what I'm going to do now. And the next time you guys will see me is going to be when I get my other gear set under here and I'm cooking food. So I think right now it is, I think it's like almost 6 o'clock now. It gets dark at about 7, 7:30. I don't know why it gets dark so early. It's just, it's going really quick now. But yeah. So this should be fun. This is a nice little wall, and yeah. And also, I mean, I could have a tiny little fire over here if there wasn't so much overlap on the ground here, because it would vent right up through, but if it got big at all, it'd just burn through the tarp, so yeah. But first time kind of doing this, but this should be fun. So I'll see you guys whenever it's time to cook food, probably. Okay guys, so got this gear. It's getting pretty cold. Getting pretty cold out now, but here's my bag right here. I'm under the tarp that I got set up. And our food is in this little lunchbox. Got our little propane canister. Pack of rice, and we got the boiler itself, and also for this cook right now we're going to need my little cast iron pan. So that's all we need out of the bag for now, but I'm going to start cooking. So this may be a longer clip, but we need to cook some food up. So sitting in my nice hammock here. First thing I gotta do is open up this, this is a Jetboil Minimo. I figured out what was wrong with it. It was just the igniter. And the reason it wouldn't ignite is because the igniter was bent down too far on it. So, right here is the little burner. Throw it over there for now on our tarp. Pretty much just real simple. It's just like any other kind of campfire cooker. Spin it on there. First thing we're going to cook is going to be the broccoli and cheese rice. So, should be pretty good. Set this on there. Get that to where it's nice and sturdy. I don't really like using the stabilizer for it. I don't know why. It works well that way. I always just leave the stabilizer off the propane or the mix that it is. But we're going to take that out because we're going to be boiling in here. Next step is get this thing and set it right on top. So, lock it in place. I'm going to open up the handles now.
And we're gonna grab out our water. For the water, I just put some water inside of my Nalgene that I've got in this bag. The Hidden Woodsman bag I have here is really nice. The side pockets that are on it has two, and it can hold a whole Nalgene in each one. So pretty much we're gonna make up our rice here. And I've learned from my own mistakes not to turn this on until the water's in here. But pretty much it says in a medium saucepan, bring 2 cups of water, 1 tablespoon of margarine, and contents of package to a boil. Stir, reduce heat, and simmer covered for 7 minutes or until rice is tender. So we just gotta bring everything in the package, the 2 cups of water, and the margarine to a boil, and then another 7 minutes once it starts boiling. So pretty self-explanatory. There's the rice I'm cooking. Just this simple rice. This is my favorite, is this kind, the broccoli and cheese. And what we're gonna do is, once this is done cooking, I'm gonna let it sit and then use my cast iron for the Canadian bacon. So this has measurements on it. We just gotta get it down to 28. Okay. Take it down a little bit more. Okay. And also, I'm pretty sure there's a fill line in here. Because I've only used this thing like one time before. But yeah, there's a 16-ounce fill line in here, so let me just get it up to that. Okay, so now that that's in there, it's definitely going to rain tonight, because you never really know around here, but I'm glad I put up the other tarp. So let's set this on here once again, and then we're going to turn the cooker on. Okay, it's turned on. Now we're just gonna pour our package of rice in here. You got little broccoli pieces in there and cheese and stuff. Dump that in. And I also did actually bring down margarine. I wasn't gonna at first, but I decided on bringing it down, because it's optional if you want to do that. But decided on it. So here's our, I brought butter instead. It's a whole tablespoon, so simple. Drop that in, and pretty much I'm gonna bring this to a boil. Once it's boiling, I'll see you guys. Okay guys, so it's getting pretty cold. The rice is done. I was gonna turn it back on when it started boiling, but figured I'd just cook it. And I'm gonna pull it off now. So, you turn the stove off, and just for a second, I'm going to stir it so none of it really sticks to the bottom. And I figured by the time we're done cooking the Canadian bacon, this will be cooled down enough that we can eat it. And I'll put this little lid on it. So, the cast iron pan I have can only cook one piece at a time. Doesn't take too long to cook, especially in a cast iron. So, okay. I'm gonna seal the rice off. Sealed. Take it off. Set it over here. So, rice is done. Next part, Canadian bacon. And that's also what we're cooking in the morning. I don't think I could bore myself with it, so should be fine. Alright, let's set this on. I can never figure out how to lock this on here. It's just one thing I couldn't do. So, let's turn this on. Hold up. Gotta bend this up. If you ever have a problem with your jet boil,
And I just figured out tonight, check the igniter and make sure it's not bent down. See, since I bent it back up there, it worked. So, I'm going to be using the bottom of the jet boil, this bowl, to hold the Canadian bacon when I'm done. So, let's set our cast iron on here. There it is. And now let's get out our Canadian bacon. So, should be pretty tasty. So, here's the bag. Zip it. I might be able to do two pieces at a time. This isn't very thick either, so let's try two pieces at a time. Might work. And there's some fat on these, so I don't really need any oil or anything. So, there we go. Let's give them a cook. Pull you guys a little closer. Because it was starting to sprinkle a minute ago. I think it stopped, though. There that is. For shoes tonight, I just have my Crocs on and some socks. It takes it being really, really cold out for my feet to go cold. I bet you right now it's about 45 out, I'd say. And there's wind. You know, it is October 4th now, so. Yep. This should not take long. Yeah, it's already sweating, is what I call that. Love cast iron. This pan, I'm pretty sure I paid, it was either $10 or $15 I paid for it. And it's got a really cool look. It's a vintage pan. I got it at a, what's it called? Flea market. And it's got like, where it was like hit with a hammer around the sides. It looks really cool. And actually, I looked it up, it's worth a good $30. So the guy told me it was 30 bucks. But, you know, I guess he knows what he's talking about. He had tons of pans too, so. But yeah, I just gotta fry up this Canadian bacon. I know I gotta flip it back to get that side crispy, but let's just get that grease going in there. But it should be really good. I won't overcook it like I did the one time. I overcooked the crap out of it. But yeah, this should be real good. The rice, baby, open up. It's setting up pretty well. So it's nice to know that you can cook a whole bag of rice in this cooker. Nice to know that. But yeah, I'm going to cook up this bacon. There's about 8 slices left that need cooked. But, I mean, it will fill half this bowl up, you know, once they're cooked. They do shrink a lot, just like bacon. So, I'm going to cook these up. And it smells really good already. And once they're cooked, we shall eat. Here's our rice, and here's our Canadian bacon. So, you'll try it out. Just give the rice a try. Real good. I haven't made rice like this while camping like this. Made other kind of rice. I never done like the packaged ones. When I was done with the cast iron pan, I poured water in it. Like the bottom started burning or something. I don't know what was going on. So I poured some water in and I'll have to season it. I sure heard an owl over there. Rice is really good, though. That's really good. I didn't eat lunch today or anything, so it should work out. But my nice little awning here is working pretty good. Pretty much, if you guys remember when I did Pine Grove Cooking was all the way at the front of the Pine Grove. I'm all the way at the back of it down here.
I'm lined up with a big meadow over here, which goes into a creek bed. There's a dirt road. And then across from there, there's a big field there. That's pretty much how it's set up here. But I like my little campground down here. And like I said, I have camped down here off camera. But you guys want to see it, it's pretty cool down here. So it's starting to rain, if you guys can hear that. And like right around dark, I'm going to have to, since I'm within driving limits of the house, I'll have to take my four-wheeler up and put Tom in. Now, if I was out further, or I wasn't around here, Mom would do them, but I figured since I can at least drive there, I'll get Tom in tonight, so. That bacon's good. I like it a lot more. Well, I don't know how I put it. I think it's equal with bacon, but they're different from each other. If you can see, it's not really autofocusing because it is getting dark. It's only about, I think it's like 6:10 right now. It's getting dark already. You know, time's changing. But, our water's boiling here. Just dumping our hot cocoa. Stir it up. This is our hot cocoa. Let that cool down. I'm going to turn the jet boil off. Heat a little bit more. We'll chill out for a bit. Because the next time you see me, it's probably going to be dark. Unless I start a fire before it's dark. Whenever I've come through here, well, whenever I've stayed down here, the deer, they come across from that field I was talking about, and they run right through this little pine grove, and they make the weirdest noises, the deer. Weirdest noises. You can see this tarp should do a good job reflecting a lot of light. I mean, that's just a flashlight, and if you see, it does a good area. So, yep. Yeah. I'm going to finish this stuff off. Stay down here until a little bit after dark. Actually, no. Probably right at dark. So, probably another 20 minutes. And I'm probably going to get some firewood gathered up for a little fire later. And then I got to go do Tom and Ducks and everything. And when I'll grab a hoodie, too, then. I'm going to need one. It got really cold. Wasn't expecting it. Of course, whenever I do my camps out in the woods, which one should have been up before this, I take everything I need then. But, you know, since I'm a couple minute drive from the house, you know, there's no point in taking tons of stuff. Glad I got that four-wheeler. It's really nice. But, yeah, this is more of a, I mean, it's definitely a camp out, but, I know Steinworth, he wanted to see. He wanted to see my little campsite I made, so here it is. Alright, I'll cut you guys off. Next time I see you, though, it's going to be dark, so I'll probably be sitting here another 10 minutes just like sipping this hot cocoa because it's going to be so hot, but yep, see you guys then. Okay, guys, I'm back down here, and as you see, it's dark out now, and I was going to come down a little bit earlier than now, but it was downpouring, and I mean downpouring. And I just come down, you know, to go to sleep now and everything. And I don't know if you can see much, but it is drenched outside. And under my little tarp setup, it is completely dry. So, take a look around. I got a little light hanging up there, but see if this works. You see my breath. I don't know if you could see that or not, but yeah, it's definitely wet outside. You can't see honestly anything. You could probably hear the rain hitting the canopy up here. Let me turn this back on. You can see there's the canopy up there, but yeah, I might make a little fire. I've got my little baggie here. Hold up. I don't really need one, but I just kind of want one. I don't know if I'll make one or not. But, yeah, like I said, it kept all of my stuff dry under this tarp. It's only been raining about half an hour. But, boy, it come out of nowhere. So, here's my little Hidden Woodsman bag. And I've got a knife in here, which I use for fires. And I've just got really anything. And since all the wood's wet, I'm going to grab a little piece of this fire starter that I use in my hot tent. So, I'm going to see if I can get one going. And I think I'll have good luck. So, let's see if I can get it going or not. Okay, guys, I got you under the canopy there. But, I got a little bit of a fire going. Don't know how, but it's definitely still raining out quite a bit. It's not like it was a bit ago, which is good, but I actually haven't camped out in the rain that much. I've been in snow. I haven't really been in the rain much, so I'm glad I was able to get the hammocks, you know, the rain system set up. So glad I was able to do that. This is a nice little log. It is so dark outside, guys. Like, it is very dark outside. I'm actually gonna flip on the night vision in a minute for you guys, so you can see further past me. So let me do that real quick, actually. I think it'd be better if I did that. Okay. So now you can watch that whole area while I'm over here. But, trying to find some wood. Bunch of wet stuff. A lot of wet stuff. But now that I got that base fire going, I'll probably be able to work on getting some of this top stuff dried off. So, this isn't as wet. Let's put that on there. It's probably gonna go out pretty easily, but a lot of wet punky wood around here. And the wood I gather is already on there. You see that like kind of stump I got there? That is like the wood I found. It's the only one that wasn't wet. So, I mean, even the one side of that piece of wood's wet. I'm gonna go ahead and turn this light off, and we're gonna sit down. So, decent little fire. Like I said, I don't need it. It's not needed at all. You know, I don't really need one, so. Yeah. Nice cozy little fire. I'm probably not gonna use my underquilt that I brought down. There's really no need for it. I'm gonna have this on moon mode so you guys can see my face. But maybe if I put on the rainfly. There you go. So you can see a little better now. But yeah, we had a full moon 2 nights ago. And now this is what we got. We got a very, very, very dark night. And I can't even see the four-wheeler over there. But it's nice. And you know, I'm happy that, you know, it held up in the rain there. It was a pretty good downpour. Like, I didn't want to take the drive back. I'd be soaked by the time I got here. So, I don't know if that fire's going to go or not. I guess I'll be the one to see on that. But, yeah. So I brought down my little speaker with me again this time. I love taking a little speaker of some sort to play some music. Obviously, I can't play it in the video part right here, but sucks it's like that on YouTube. Can't really play music, but fire's going a little bit here. Nice little fire going.
Here's my fire grate. This thing's soaked. Sucks you guys can't really tell other than the noise of the rain. But it's not like it's a storm or anything. It's just a, you know, it's just like a fall rain is what I call it. A fall rain. You know, it's October 4th, so you gotta expect it to get cold soon here. Come so early this year, and you know, it sucks I'm finally driving at the end of summer and spring, and but I got all the fall to drive and everything, so that should be fun. You know, there's so many hammocks I've had, and they just wouldn't hold my weight. And, you know, there's a few that can hold my weight. Like, I have an Eno hammock that got sent to me, which I really appreciate. And I'll be using that when it's... Honestly, I could have used that tonight, but I did not know how it was going to be, you know. You never really go off what they say. So... Yeah, I guess that's our little fire. It's not big at all, but like I said, I don't need one. Reason I'm doing such a long clip here and talking is, you know, I'm probably gonna go to bed after this clip, but this did hold up really nice. It really did. I'm surprised with it. You can see behind me. Hold up. See, that's the back wall. The light just flipped, of course. But, so you can see, this is the back wall, and where I was cooking. I'm sitting on the opposite side now looking at the fire. But, it's nice. So, I might try to find a little bit more wood to stoke this fire up. And, next time I see you, it's probably when I'm going to bed, so. I threw on a sweatshirt. Surprisingly, it's not really keeping me warm, but I don't even have to wear this, honestly. It doesn't do much. Wherever there's smoke, there's fire. Look at all that smoke. Holy cow. Alright, so that's what I'm gonna do. Enough of this really long clip already. I'm gonna see if I can find some more wood, stoke it up, listen to music for a bit, and then I'll say goodnight to you guys, so. Yep. Hopefully I don't wake up during the night. I know I do that a lot, because I'm used to the hot tent by now. And, yeah. We'll see how it goes. So, I like hammock camping quite a bit. I also like tent camping. I like hot tent camping. You know, I'm all over the place. A lot of people are like, you know, what do you like better? Do you like hammock or do you like tent? And, I can't choose one, honestly. They both have their own flaws, and they both have their own good things about them, so. Okay, I'll quit talking. Let me get some wood on here. Get it nice and bright, and then we'll tuck in. Okay, guys, so I'm going to go to bed. You see behind me, fire's going a little bit better now. And I got to make sure you guys are in a good place, the camera. So if anything happens, you're not getting wet. So before I lay down in here, I'm going to go ahead and tuck that nice and away in this bag and set it under another bag just to make sure that doesn't happen. So, yep. I'm going to go to bed and hopefully I don't wake up too many times. But you guys will know if I do a little update. So, yep. Going to bed. I'll probably be sleeping within like half an hour. I'll listen to music and stuff for a bit and watch the fire and then I'll go to bed. But, yeah. See you guys in the morning, hopefully.
Okay, guys, so just a little update. I'm starting to hear cars and stuff down on the main road. It's 4:52 in the morning. Pretty much since, like, right after I shut the camera off, I went to bed. And it wasn't too cold, but, like, now it's, like, really cold. I kept taking, like, little naps up until 1:30 in the morning. And then, after then, I finally fell asleep until now, which is 4:30. Well, that's when I woke up. And, as soon as I woke up, I saw a shooting star right through that patch right there. And, a semi scared the heck out of me. But, surprised there isn't a frost out. But I'm gonna try not to leave the hammock here because it's nice and warm down where my feet are up here. But, yeah, I just want to do an update. And it sucked last night because, you know, I wanted to have the full hammock open, but I know that, you know, my breathing would be messed up in the morning, so I don't want to do that because it is pretty cold. So I had to pretty much torture myself inside of the tent or inside of the hammock, and I had to close it up all the way, and just it was so hot, like breathing. But okay, I just wanted to do an update, and everything's held up, and it did keep raining actually until like a little bit before I went to bed again. It kept raining, so, but it did stop. But yeah, it's nice I can see. You guys can't see, can you? Hold up, let's try something real quick before I shut this off. We find the infrared. Okay, no, you can't see. Pretty much that patch there where I saw the shooting star, the Big Dipper's right there. It goes like this, where the scoop is. It's right there. So, but, okay. I'm going to try to go bed for another, like, 2.5 hours. And then it's time for breakfast. So, see you then. Okay guys, so I know this camera angle is a little weird, but yeah, so I think I'm guessing it's probably 8:30, 9 o'clock right now, so I'm guessing, because I fell back asleep about 10 minutes after I was done filming the last clip, and I had a fire going. I'm talking about when it was still dark out, not like the clips I put. But I did a little fire. It didn't really go, but I just kind of fell asleep anyways. And, yeah. As you can see, it is... Hold up. It is raining out. It's still raining, like, right now. It's just a rainy fall day. But I mean, it's been raining all morning. All morning it's been raining. You can see how much. Lots of water. But I think it's time for breakfast.
Okay guys, so I decided on scrambled cheesy eggs with bacon bits. So ran up to the house. Mom was up now, so I went in and got some eggs, cheese, bacon bits. And since I didn't know how much water I was going to need, I just grabbed a bottle of water instead of my Nalgene. So I don't have any left in the Nalgene. I'll just have it in the bottle. And yeah, I had to wash the pans also. Well, the pot and the pan. So yeah, it is a cold morning. I tell you what, that sleeping bag stays really, really warm. I'm gonna keep calling it a sleeping bag, guys. I'm sorry. Get the point, the hammock. But, first we're gonna start with our hot cocoa so it can cool down. Let's turn this on. Alright. Now, see?
that got bent somehow. So we're gonna bend it back down. And just like that, we got a burner. So, a bottle of water here. There's a little pine needle floor. There we go. Go to about there. Whenever I'm camping, I don't know why, but I really like just a strong hot cocoa. I don't put as much water usually. Nah, it is a lot of water, don't get me wrong, but I'm gonna turn this all the way on. And yeah, hopefully we'll have some hot cocoa in a minute. So I'm gonna cut you guys off for now. And once it's done boiling, I'll get back with you guys. Because the eggs won't take long, so see you in a second. Okay guys, it's almost boiling already. A couple things I wanted to say though. I have my underquilt right here, this blue bag, and I didn't even need to use it last night because the sleeping bag kept me warm. But see, I call it a sleeping bag again. Also, if I can get over there, this is the speaker that I use. I want the setup, it looks nice. There we go. But it's a JBL Go 2. That's what I use whenever I go solo. I have a bigger speaker I take when I'm with friends, but I mean, I recommend you take a speaker with you, because I listen to, like, Colter Wall, music like that. If you guys know Colter Wall, I just listen to music like that. I don't know, it just makes it feel a lot more like a old campsite to me. So you can see, this is already boiling. Jet boil's really good. Sucks I didn't look it up sooner. It was literally a 2-second fix. But I'm lazy sometimes. But here's our little egg carton. We got 3 eggs, a little bag of cheese and bacon bits, our fork, and our spoon for our hot cocoa. So let's take this off and put our cup of joe over here. I'm gonna leave this on a little simmer for a second while I'm waiting. Keep it going. It does put off a good amount of heat. It's really nice. I have this old pack of hot cocoa that I've took around with me multiple times. I haven't had it yet, so it's time to have it. It's always good, you know, hot cocoa. It's in its little foil pack in there, so. There we go. Nice, nice, nice. Set our garbage over here, I guess. And stir. I got a little marshmallows in there. I highly recommend, I know I recommend a lot of stuff, but this is stuff that I enjoy. These are mugs from Walmart. They're like a $5 mug, a camp mug, I'm pretty sure they call it. And it's in the camping section. And these things, you can boil in them, you can use them as cups. You can do all kinds of stuff. You can cook in them. I recommend them. I mean, there's some things that are garbage at Walmart. Well, a lot of things. But, there's some stuff I get. And a lot of my stuff is from Walmart. And it's pretty good. So, yeah. That's one thing I'd recommend. It's these mugs. And they've got the fold-out handles as well. Smells really good. So, that's going to sit over there. We'll drink that whenever our eggs are done. But now, we're just going to set our pan on. Actually, I'm going to do the eggs and then put them back in the pan because I know a lot of times cast iron don't like sitting on top of there. It's very slippery. It's heavy. So we're going to go ahead and put our eggs in a little bit as they're cooking. I'll dump the cheese in. But here's our little cast iron. I seasoned it, washed it back up. Something hard to crack on. Let's use our JBL speaker. There we go. This is going to be our cracking table, I guess. I don't see why not.
And I got that all messed up. All over my hands. I got some water left. I'll just use that to wash it off. I don't want no raw eggs on my hands. Man, I'm all over the place with these eggs. I'm stupid. I've got a cast iron pan in front of me. I'm like, oh, what can I crack these eggs on? Okay, let's get this off my hands now. Because I hate the feeling of eggs on my hands. I don't know who does like the feeling of eggs on their hands, but... there we go. But, we're going to put these on now. Let's bring this burner back over to here. I'm going to crank it to about there. And, anytime I stir these, I'm going to hold the pan. Oh, I must have got some, yeah, there's pine needles on the bottom of the pan. But, I'm just going to keep cooking these. And once they're... man, this is uneven right here. Once they start cooking and I start scrambling a bit, I'm going to add in the cheese and bacon bits. Like I said, it's just in a little bag here. You know, I was going to do the Canadian bacon, but I don't know. It's just really... I think I was Canadian baconed out after all that Canadian bacon last night, so I didn't really want any. But, yeah, I don't know if you guys can see, but they're already cooking in the one spot here on the bottom. It's turning white. I'm going to do these on low heat. I don't really feel like burning these because the jet boil will burn stuff in seconds if you don't watch it. You know, especially in the center. Right now, all these eggs are cooking in the center, so... I'm going to go ahead and cut you guys off, and once I add the cheese and bacon bits, I'll cut back in. Okay guys, I'm going to add in the bacon bits of cheese real quick. Pine needle in there.
Hold up.
Get that out. I want that in there. Last night I was eating one of the pieces of Canadian bacon, and then I started tasting pine needles. So, and these are going to be a little too cheesy. I mean, that's not bad. Don't get me wrong. A lot of people scramble the cheese in right when they do it. That's how my mom does it, but I kind of like it when it's now. I don't know. Looks like they melt better. Should put a little butter in here, but it'll still work. I haven't had scrambled eggs in a while. You know, when it comes to being at the house and cooking, I do not cook at all. I can, trust me, I'm pretty good at cooking. But whenever I cook outside, it just tastes so much better. And I always cook outside whenever I'm, well, obviously camping or something like that. But I don't know, I just really enjoy cooking while camping. It always tastes better to me. And I don't know. I mean, this right here is three ingredients, and it's just so good. Really, really good. So. Let me go ahead and turn this off. Move it out of the way. This thing's really nice. It is. I do enjoy the jet boils. We're gonna have to toss these around for another minute because cast iron stays hot. Another good thing I like about cast iron. And those are some good eggs right there. So I'm gonna flip the camera over to me. And
you start eating these eggs while they're nice and hot. Hot cocoa is still hot over there. I'm sure I could drink some now, but looks pretty hot still, but straight out of the pan. It's only about halfway up the handle of the heat, so. Mmm. Hear him sizzling? Hear all the blue jays? That's when you tell fall's coming. I also hear a chickadee behind me. Well, it's already fall. I mean, winter. Blue jays are really going off over there. Take a little sip of that for now. It's still really hot. I love this little cast iron, though. I do. Didn't hear any animals last night. I heard the owl when I told you guys I heard it. And that was half an hour before it was dark. Pretty sure. All the leaves are changing. The trees over there behind me. How many different colors are there? That's where all the blue jays are right now. Looks like I'm in a wall tent. After I'm done eating here, I'm going to go ahead and pack stuff up. Okay, guys, you just finished the eggs. I have some visitors. I keep jumping around. I have a bunch of itches and stuff over here. They keep flying around. Let's see if I'll get them on camera or not. He was just sitting there watching me. I think it was a titmouse. My cocoa's almost gone too, but. I don't know if they'll come back around. I don't know if they're eating berries or what. I don't know what they're doing. I think they're just watching me. Hey guys, so I have everything packed up. And last thing to do is let this pine bough down. Like I said, it gives a little bit of cover here. So I figured I'll just make a little toggle there. And just have it to where I can pull it up and let it down. So I was gonna leave the tarp, but I don't know. I feel like I wouldn't come down, and then it would get ruined and it would sit here. So I figured I'll do it all now. So I took it down, and everything's packed up. The only thing left now is the camera and the bag. So as you can see, I'm pretty sure you can see the fire. Couldn't see it. Right there's the fire. There was wood in there. Couldn't get it going last night. It was going for a bit, but then it stopped. But as you can see, there's our little area. It's going to be stopping, going, and there's the four-wheeler. Look at the trees over there. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed. And, yeah, it was a nice little campsite, good food, and, yeah, now you guys were able to see my campsite that I made, my little homemade campsite, but, yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video, and, thanks for watching, guys, see you in the next one.